Hi everyone, in this video I want to show you how to create a mirrored volume on Ubuntu Linux. I'm gonna also show you towards the end of the video how to recover a mirrored volume in case one of the drives that is part of the mirror fails. So mirror is RAID 1 and I'm gonna be using Ubuntu 22.04, but the instructions I'm gonna show you will also apply to other versions of Ubuntu. So let's start. So this here is my Ubuntu machine. And the first thing you need to do, of course, is to install two hard drives in your PC so that you can put these two hard drives as a RAID 1 volume. So here I've added two hard drives. Let me show you the disks, how they are now in my machine. So I'm gonna go to the applications here, and under utilities, you have disks. So you see here, I have three hard drives. This is the boot hard drive. I'm not going to touch it because the RAID volume, I'm going to create it on these two hard drives here. And this will be to put my important files and folders on these two hard drives. So this is disk. I'm going to keep it open because we're going to use it afterwards to show you how to get information from it. So now we need to open a terminal window. Let's open a terminal window. In Ubuntu, it is Ctrl-Alt-T. The first thing you need to do is to install a utility called MDADM, which is Multiple Disk and Device Management. So to install it, key in this command here in the terminal window, sudo apt install MDADM, hit enter, put the password for your user, and if you are prompted to press yes, press yes. Here I wasn't prompted to press yes to continue the installation. And now the utility is installed. So the next step we need to do here is to get the names of the hard drives that we are going to configure as a RAID volume. So go to disks here, and you see the first one is /dev/sdb, and the second one is /dev/sdc. So here, let me clear the screen. So now that we installed the MDADM utilities, and we have also the names of the hard drives, we need to configure a partition on these hard drives, and this partition should be a Linux RAID partition. So let's do this. You need to do this command to perform, and I'm gonna perform this command on both drives. So let's start with /dev/sdb. So key in sudo fdisk/dev/sdb, hit enter, type n for new. And here it's asking you what is the partition type you need to create. So it is a primary partition. So key in P and press enter. So here you can simply press enter to get the number of the partition. It defaults to 1, and this is what we want. Also for the first sector, just press enter, and last sector, also press enter. So now at this stage, you see that it created a partition of type Linux. We need to change this partition. And to change this partition, you need to key in T and then press enter. And here, if you don't know what is the name of the Linux RAID partition, it will tell you press L to see what are the partitions that you can create. So I'm gonna just press L to show you. So capital L, and here you have all the partition types that you can create. And the partition that we need to create is FD, and FD is Linux RAID Auto. So here simply key in FD and small letters, and then press enter, and you see that the partition changed from Linux to Linux RAID Auto Detect. So now we need to write these changes to the drive. Just key in W and press enter. And now let's repeat the same thing for the SDC drive. Sudo fdisk/dev/sdc. I'm gonna do it quickly because I've done it before. And for new, primary, 1, enter, enter, T, FD, and now it changed to Linux RAID. Let's try the changes. So you see the drives here. It is now partition type Linux RAID Auto, as you see it here. And the name of the device now, it's called SDB1 and SDC1. So now the next step is to create the RAID volume using these two drives. So let me clear the screen once again. So this is a command in order to create the RAID volume. So sudo MDADM --- create, and here you need to create a volume. So let's call it /dev/MD0. So now you need to specify the RAID level. So to do this, put --level, and because it is RAID 1, it means it is mirror, equal mirror. And now you need to specify the number of the drives that are going to participate in this mirrored volume, and you need to specify the name of these drives. So continue the command with this, minus minus RAID dash devices equal to, and here you need to specify the names here, slash dev sdc1 and then slash dev sdb1. So we're gonna start with sdb1, so slash dev slash sdb1 space slash dev slash sdc1 and hit enter, key in yes and hit enter, and now it created the RAID volume. And you see under disks here it created a RAID volume. It named it dev md0 as we named it here, and it is a RAID 1 array also as we specified, because it's a mirror. So the next step now is to create a partition on this RAID volume. So in disks here, you see here the configuration, click on it, and then click on format partition and give it any name. I'm gonna give it a name, important. And then here I'm gonna keep it for Linux. So internal disks for use with Linux, and then simply press next, and then format. Put the password. And now you see that the partition is created, but it is not yet mounted. So let's mount the partition. Press here on the play button, it will mount the partition, and you see it is mounted under media KST important, and this is the device name. So let's see now the mirror status. So let me clear the screen and key in the following command, sudo mdadm minus minus detail space slash dev slash md0, and here it will tell you the RAID information. So you see here you have RAID 1, and you see that you have two devices, and active devices are two, and working devices are two. And now the status is that it is syncing, and it is 29% complete. So now we have our RAID volume created. If I go under files and under other locations, you see that we have now the important location here. So let's create a file under this location. Let me open LibreOffice. And in LibreOffice, I'm going to create any file. Let's call it test RAID. And then let's save it. So I'm going to choose to save it under the important partition. And then click on save. So here's the file. It is now protected with RAID 1. And I saved the file to show you when I remove a hard drive now from the computer that we still have access to this file. So let me close everything here. And I'm going to show you how I'll be removing a hard drive, but I'm going to wait before until the syncing is over. So now the drive synced. So the next step now I'm going to show you is that if you lose a drive, first, if you still can access your files, I'm going to demonstrate this to you, and then how you can add the drive and then re-add it to the mirror. So let me simulate first that I lost a drive. And now if I go to disks under utils, you're going to see that I no longer have this disk. So it will be removed here. Give it a moment. It will update. And you see it was removed. So now Ubuntu noticed that we don't have the drive anymore. So now if I go to see the details of the RAID volume, it's gonna tell you now it is degraded and that we have only one active device, as you notice here. And it should have two devices. So let's see if we can still access the file that we created under the important volume, so the RAID volume. So this is it here. So it is here, and the file is still accessed. So we didn't lose our information. So now let me show you how to re-add a hard drive and then how to add it to the RAID volume. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna simulate that I added a new hard drive. And now you see it's so here that it is here. So let's see now the RAID status. Of course, it will not add it automatically. So let me show you how to add it. First, you need to initialize the newly added hard drive so that it will be recognized as a Linux RAID auto. So let's do this, sudo fdisk slash dev slash sdc. And now we need to repeat the steps to initialize this hard drive as a Linux RAID auto. Type n for new, and then primary, and then enter for one, enter, enter. And then here t to change the type here for Linux RAID. So this one here, it should be changed to Linux RAID. So T, and then FD, enter, and you see it is now Linux RAID, and then W to write. So let me clear the screen. And now we need to inform MDADM to add this hard drive to the RAID volume that we have. And this is a command that we need to perform. So sudo MDADM minus minus manage. And then what are we going to manage? We are going to manage the RAID volume slash dev slash MD0. Remember, we named the RAID volume MD0. So what are we going to add? We are going to add the newly created partition that is on the hard drive that we added. And when we initialized the partition just before this command, it changed its name to SDC1. So we need to continue the command like this, minus minus add slash dev slash SDC1. And now it tells you that it added SDC1 to the RAID volume, which is dev MD0. So let's check now the details of this RAID volume. Sudo MDADM minus minus detail slash dev slash MD0. And you're going to notice here that now we have two RAID devices and the total is two instead of one. But for now, the active devices is one because now SDC1 is still being rebuilt. So now MDADM is rebuilding the RAID volume. So I'm going to give it a couple of minutes and come back and show you how it is rebuilt and how everything is working. While waiting for the RAID volume to be rebuilt, if you have any comments or questions, please put them in the comments section below and I'll be happy to reply to all your questions and to all your comments. And if you like this video so far, please consider subscribing to my channel and giving this video a like. So now the volume is almost rebuilt. Let's see if it finished. And you see now that the volume is finished and the state is clean and we have two active devices on this RAID volume. So we corrected the RAID volume. So that was it for this video. I hope that you liked this video and you found it useful. If you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and it will help the channel greatly. And this way, you'll not miss any future videos I make. I'm Eloy. I want to thank you all for watching, and see you in the next video.